Hello everyone, we are about to start this lecture on online lecture. So all the participants are requested to kindly mute themselves. So many of our participants have already joined us. So I think I may request Dr. Pratibha ma'am to kindly switch on their camera. And kindly mute yourself. All the participants are requested to kindly mute them. Since many of the participants have already joined, so we are just starting this online lecture. Hello everyone. Namaskar. I would like to thank first all the participants to join this online lecture on research writing process. This lecture is being organized by the Department of Biotechnology of Noida Institute of Engineering and Technology in association with Institute Innovation Council NIET. I am Dr. Arvind from the Department of Biotechnology, Noida Institute of Engineering and Technology. NIT is one of the premier engineering and management institute of Uttar Pradesh, and I am very proud to say that it is the only institute in UP to be recognized by all the four rankings and accrediting government organizations. We are six program NBA accredited, NAC A grade, NIRF ranked in the band of 200 to 250 and top 50 in innovation under ARIA 2020 ranking. It is also one of the first private institute to get autonomous status in Uttar Pradesh as well. The Department of Biotechnology has a strong research base. Here we offer BTech and MTech in biotechnology. The department has many government funded research projects to its credit. The Department of Biotechnology organizes various webinars, seminars and other literary events on a regular basis. The Institute Innovation Council at NIET is also working to explore the different areas like innovation, startup, social and environment. And here we are trying hard to extend the reach of this IIC to the society through its activities and efforts. The IIC NIET, being a member of it, it's my privilege to introduce one of the event which I have taken up to educate the youth about the technical writing. And for this, we have designed a series of lecture and hands-on session on research writing. It will also include the patent drafting and writing the proposals to the various funding agencies. In this series, today, as you all know, we have invited a very young and talented researcher from the Department of Biotechnology, NIET, to deliver a talk on research writing process. So I would like to welcome Dr. Prithibha Pandey. First of all, let me just tell you about her and achievements that she has got in just a short span of time. She's an expert in cancer biology and also on water remediation, chemo prevention using the natural products, in silico as well as in vitro techniques. She is also the recipient of different research grants. She got the grant of rupees 3 lakhs under the CRIP program of TEQIP3 from AKTU Lucknow. She is also the recipient of the grant of Women Scientist Scholarship of rupees 21 lakh by the Department of Science and Technology, Government of India. She is also the life member of various organizations, various agencies like Indian Science Congress Association, Society for Biotechnology India, and Swadeshi Science Movement. Without any further delay, I would like to hand over the session to Dr. Prithibha ma'am. Over to you, ma'am.
Very good afternoon to all of you. Thank you so much, sir, for introducing me in such a high manner. I am Dr. Prithibha Pandey, and I'm working as assistant professor in the Department of Biotechnology, Greater Noida. Firstly, I would like to thank Dr. Arvind Arya, sir, and our HOD ma'am, Dr. Rashmi ma'am, for providing me this opportunity to discuss a very important issue, that is research writing, which is highly important for your professional as well as personal development. So there are various reasons why we have chosen this topic. Because many of the teachers, they feel that why to do research, or even many of the students, they say, why to do this? What is the significance of this research writing and basically research? So to answer these queries and to develop, or you can say to stimulate the research ability in, or to inculcate this research in our students as well as in some of our faculty members, I have tried this session to stimulate the research habit into you all. So allow me to speak on this significant topic. And do let me know if you have liked this performance. So let me share my screen. Sir, is the screen visible to you also?
Yeah, ma'am, kindly put it on projector mode. Slideshow.
Sir, is it okay, sir?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
I'll start my lecture with the saying of our very renowned scientist, Albert Einstein, as he said that if we knew what we were doing, then it would not be called research. So research is not about something to repeat that work similarly, but to use the knowledge of our existing literatures to get new innovations or to further expand our knowledge. We need, that is known as research. There are other scientists also who have defined research, like Martin Shuttleworth. He explained research that in a way that to include several data or information for the advancement of your own knowledge. As I said earlier also, that to expand our knowledge as to or to expand our wisdom, there is a need to do research. So research is not about innovating, it's about how significantly or how important you collect the data as well use analyze those information in order to increase your understanding about a particular topic or your area of interest. So I would be discussing all the different things in this lecture. Now the important part is that what would be the outcome of my lecture or what my listener would get after attending this lecture. So after attending this lecture, I believe that the listener would be able to get the concept of scientific research and innovation, as well as the listener would be able to identify or to conceptualize the essential steps that are being involved in their research writing process. And the last important step is you should execute your work in a time efficient manner, because agar aap kisi cheez ko time efficient manner mein execute nahi kar pate, then that will not leave a good impact. So all the three things, I hope this lecture will definitely help you to gain this. So whenever you start research, I hope you all will agree with the fact that these four interrogatives comes into your mind whenever you think about this word research. I definitely believe that you will get these four interrogatives into your brain. That is what, why, how, and whom. And my dear friends, if you can sort out these four interrogatives, or if you can answer these interrogatives nicely, then I assure you that you can write a very good research article, or you can say proposal or anything. You can conduct your research in an efficient manner if you can answer these four interrogatives. I would be discussing all the four different interrogatives line by line. Let's start with the first. That is, what is research? Because that is very important to know what is research actually. First of all, you should always should know that from where these words have derived, or these words have come. So research word that is derived from a very old French word, that is "recherche," means to seek or to search. And the word itself, if you can see that it is a combination of two words, that is your "re" plus "search." "Re" means what? That is to repeat, and "search" is to find something. So actual meaning kya hai? Aap kisi cheez ko repeat karoge. Repeat kis cheez ko karoge? The thing which is previously published, jo pehle hamare scientist ya jis bhi field mein. This is not related to only biotechnology, or you can say science. This is relevant to all the different fields, including science, management, or any other field. So means what? Whatever research has been done, or whatever the work has been published before, if you want to innovate something, you have to take the reference of the previous studies. So this is what? This is research. That means you are extracting the data, or you are expanding your knowledge by taking help from your previously published literature. जैसे कि हिंदी में भी हम कहते हैं कि अगर हमें कुछ चीज सर्च करनी है, या हमें अगर अपनी नई क्वेरी आंसर करनी है, तो हमें पहले अपनी हिस्ट्री को देखना पड़ता है, बिकॉज विदाउट नोइंग हिस्ट्री यू कैन नॉट क्रिएट अ हिस्ट्री. सो इट्स a very important thing, that is you repeat to find something innovative. Now, many of my students, they generally ask this question that, ma'am, why we should do research? What is the significance of this research in our life? So I would like to tell them that research is not only a means of earning money or to publishing paper. No, it is not stick to that particular level. It is not that we publish papers to gain promotions. If I'm talking in the scenario of faculty members or teaching fraternity, many of us believe that publishing paper is just to gain a promotion or to gain incentives. No. What I believe that research helps to stimulate your thinking and analytical skill. Kis tarike se aapki analytical skill stimulate hoti hai? Obviously, when you go through the previously published literature, then you get to know about what work you can do in it. So definitely, if you read the previously published literature, then you can stimulate or you can increase your, you can do the betterment of your thinking and analytical skills. So that's why research is very much needed. And second, obviously, you would be able to define your academic career as well as personal interest by doing this research. And third and important thing, when your analytical and thinking skill is developed, okay, that is, you have stimulated this or aapki skill bahut achhi ho gayi, to definitely aapko fayda kya hoga? You would be expand your knowledge, aapki knowledge badhegi, and obviously apart from your classroom topics, you would be able to understand a wider other topics also that are very much important in your daily to daily life. Because getting a degree is not that important. What I believe many of us feels that, okay, we have got this degree. No, that is not significant. If you are unable to get anything, or if you are unable to put a, you know, aap kisi cheez ki agar chhaap nahi chhodte ho, then it is not just ki aapne degree le li. So I believe that if you will do research, then definitely you will explore a wider area or what is happening around you or what better you can do for your society. And next, fourth point, definitely ये तो बहुत ही important है कि अगर आप कुछ चीजें establish कर पाए, अगर आप अपनी knowledge को expand कर पाए, तो obviously नया कुछ आप innovate ही करोगे. और once you publish a research article or you do innovation, then you can develop connections with other distinguished faculty members in their particular field. Suppose if you are a student of management or any other engineering branch or pharmacy, what you can do, if you publish any research article, then obviously you would be able to develop connections with all those distinguished members who have already created a very good remark in those areas. So these are some of the important benefits. I hope now my students would be get motivated to do research. Now the next thing is that, now you have understood the meaning of research, or you have got a little bit idea that why to do research and all that. So now the important thing which comes, that how to write research paper. It is not only research paper, basically, how to design a research, how to design a research proposal or anything. So we would be moving on to this in detail. So पहले research paper की जगह आपको एक word, I hope you all get this word, आप लोग familiar होते होंगे जब भी आप research paper की बात करते हो, तो आप एक terminology से face करते होंगे, that is your manuscript, which is very important. क्या है ये manuscript? Many times my students used to ask, ma'am, what is manuscript? क्या है ये? So what is this? This is nothing. This is just a draft of your research work. आप जो भी रिसर्च डिजाइन, जो भी रिसर्च पूरा वर्क मेथोडोलॉजी एंड एवरीथिंग, सारे कंपोनेंट्स व्हिच आई विल बी शोइंग इन द कमिंग, इन माय कमिंग स्लाइड्स, आपको वो सारे पॉइंट्स जो हैं, जो भी एक ड्राफ्ट तैयार करते हो, दैट इज योर मैन्युस्क्रिप्ट. तो मैन्युस्क्रिप्ट इज नथिंग बट अ ड्राफ्ट ऑफ योर रिसर्च वर्क, जो कि आप किसी जर्नल में सबमिट करोगे पब्लिश करने के लिए, और यू विल सबमिट टू डिफरेंट गवर्नमेंट एजेंसीज टू गेट ग्रांट्स और एनीथिंग. सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट लाइक योर पीस ऑफ वर्क, जो भी आपका ड्राफ्ट है वर्क का. अब कई बार हम क्या करते हैं, ओके सम सर्टेन टाइम्स हमारी ओरिजिनल रिसर्च होती है. ओरिजिनल रिसर्च मींस वी आर डिजाइनिंग समथिंग नोवेल और वी आर क्रिएटिंग समथिंग व्हिच हैज नॉट बीन डन अर्लियर. इतना भी नहीं कि पहले नहीं हुआ है, ऑब्वियसली आपका जो भी डेटा पहले पब्लिश हुआ है उसको यूटिलाइज करते हुए, उस नॉलेज को यूटिलाइज करते हुए हाउ यू आर क्रिएटिंग अ नोवेल थिंग. दैट मींस योर वर्क which you have performed, which in which you have collected the data, you have performed the whole experiments, that is your original work. That means your new research findings, or you can say conceptual analysis, that is your original paper. Another category is also there, review article. Review article means in this what is basically like here what you do in this, that you arrange the data in a chronological manner. Chronological manner मतलब आपका past 10 years में what are the advancements being done in that particular area. Here you do not perform any experiments, but you just assemble all the previously published research to make you generalize a idea that you say okay these are the different findings jo is field mein hui hai and aap logo ko ek future perspective dete ho ki ye log in data ko collect karke is tarike se naya kuch advancements kar sakte hain. So this is also a very important research you can say you all can do. Ye koi bhi kar sakta hai. For this you don't need to perform experiments in the lab, you just have to sit at your own टेबल. आप अपने घर में इत्मीनान से बैठी है, रीड मोर एंड मोर पेपर्स एंड राइट रिव्यू आर्टिकल्स. इफ यू हैव दैट क्रिएटिविटी दैट यू कैन एस्टेब्लिश लिंक्स बिटवीन डिफरेंट स्टडीज, जो भी स्टडीज हुई हैं, हाउ नाइसली और ब्यूटिफुल यू कैन लिंक अप ऑल द डिटेल्स एंड आप एक जनरलाइज करके आइडिया बनाते हो, दैट इज योर रिव्यू आर्टिकल एंड दिस यू ऑल कैन डू. सबसे बेस्ट पार्ट है दैट यू डू नॉट नीड टू परफॉर्म एक्सपेरिमेंट्स इन इट. Again, one category is that mini review. Mini review means short write-up. It is similar to your review article, but in mini review, this is shorter one. Like you are not going to explain each and every topic of that particular area, but you are focusing on some important aspects. Similarly, there is another category is your short communication. This is nothing, but it is just a concise report on a particular subject. Letter to editor, this you cannot write, but these are means invited. These editors, or you can say chief editors of the journals, they invite our esteemed professors as well as jo distinguished persons hote hain us field ke, un logo ko wo chief editors, they invite them to write a letter to editor and they publish that. For this particular section you need to work very hard, my dear friends, because you have to do something very extraordinary, then only a chief editor of the journal would ask you to write letter to editor. So these are certain manuscript categories. A whole lecture is needed, but here I have taken a short glimpse that aap log ko ek cheez clear ho jaye ki what is manuscript, what are the different categories. In this lecture, I would be discussing on original paper only. Now, as you can see in the screen, I have tried to show you both the articles. One is your research article, another is your review article. As you can see in the title, kya hai review article? If you can see clearly in both the articles, I have done work on JAV1. अगर आप ध्यान से देखो, दोनों में ही हम बात कर रहे हैं कैंसर की, रिव्यू में भी और रिसर्च में भी. और दोनों में ही अगर आप देख रहे हो प्रोटीन या जो भी कह लो, अगर ले मैन लैंग्वेज में, इफ आई एम नॉट मेकिंग इट बोरिंग ओनली क्योंकि बिकॉज बायोटेक्नोलॉजिस्ट के लिए तो या फार्मासिस्ट पीपल के लिए तो अंडरस्टैंडिंग दिस जीन प्रोटीन इज वेरी इजी, बट फॉर अदर स्ट्रीम आई फाइंड इट लिटिल डिफिकल्ट फॉर देम. सो लेट मी मेक इट वेरी सिंपल. हेयर व्हाट आई हैव डन, एक छोटा सा ग्लिम्स दे रही हूँ कि व्हाट आई हैव डन इन दिस लेक्चर. आई हैव सिलेक्टेड अ पर्टिकुलर जीन, राइट? आप जीन कह लो या फिर अगर आप लेमैन लैंग्वेज में कि इससे कैंसर हो रहा है, मैंने एक टारगेट सिलेक्ट किया है. अगर आप ध्यान से देख रहे हो रिव्यू आर्टिकल में आई हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड द होल थ्योरी ऑफ दिस JAV1 प्रोटीन, हाउ इट इज लीडिंग टू कैंसर, एंड आई हैव नॉट मेकिंग इट स्पेसिफिक दैट टू विच कैंसर इट इज एक्चुअली द मेन कॉजेटिव एजेंट. हेयर आई हैव एक्सप्लेन दैट how this JAB1 is responsible for any form of cancer. Whereas, अगर आप रिसर्च आर्टिकल में देखोगे तो इन रिसर्च आर्टिकल आई हैव सिलेक्टेड दिस JAB1 जीन इन पर्टिकुलर स्पेसिफिक कैंसर दैट इज सर्वाइकल कैंसर. सो हेयर आई हैव डन द वर्क इन दिस रिसर्च आर्टिकल. वेयर एज रिव्यू में देयर इज नो वर्क डन. व्हाट हैज बीन डन इन दिस, सारी स्टोरीज कलेक्ट की गई हैं फ्रॉम द प्रीवियसली पब्लिश्ड रिसर्च. जिस साइंटिस्ट ने भी JAB1 से रिलेटेड कोई सिग्निफिकेंट काम पब्लिश किया होगा तो उन सारे काम को हमने एक क्रोनोलॉजिकल ऑर्डर में अरेंज करके वी हैव डन दिस रिव्यू आर्टिकल. सो बट सिंस टाइम इज लेस एंड दिस लेक्चर इज मेनली फोकस्ड ऑन रिसर्च आर्टिकल, सो वी वुड बी फोकसिंग ऑन रिसर्च आर्टिकल. Now, before writing any research article, what are the different parts you should focus on or how you can design a research paper? Because experiments to hum lab mein perform kar lete hain. It's quite easy for us to perform. Kisi bhi field ke hote hain, hum aram se experiments perform kar dete hain. But to showcase your work effectively or on a global platform, you need to write your work in an effective manner. How you can write? These are some of the important points which you need to study if you want to design an effective research paper. I would be discussing each and every point one by one. But before writing any research paper, as I said, you need to do the review of literature. Kai baar aapka teacher बोलता होगा, स्टूडेंट्स स्पेशली, आई एम नॉट सेइंग फॉर द फैकल्टी मेंबर्स, और यू कैन से अगर इफ देयर इज एनी पीएचडी स्कॉलर्स आर देयर इन माय लेक्चर, सो मेनी टाइम्स यू हैव फेस्ड दिस वर्ड दैट इज रिव्यू ऑफ लिटरेचर. व्हाट इज दिस रिव्यू ऑफ लिटरेचर एंड व्हाई टू डू दिस रिव्यू ऑफ लिटरेचर? जब आप पीएचडी ज्वाइन करते हो देन ऑल्सो इन द फर्स्ट ईयर योर गाइड आस्क और योर सुपरवाइजर आस्क यू टू डू extensive review of literature. And even if you are a student of final year, if you are doing your project in BTech final year or B Pharma or M Pharma, you are asked to do review of literature. Kyun kar rahe hum ye review of literature? Why it is needed? And what is this review of literature? Review of literature where you study the previously published literature. Kyunki aaj jo bhi current issue hum dekh rahe hain ya hum koi issue aaj हम स्टडी कर रहे हैं, इफ यू आर ट्राइंग टू फाइंड द सॉल्यूशन ऑफ दोस इश्यूज, वी नीड टू नो द बैकग्राउंड, हाउ आर साइंटिस्ट और हाउ अदर पर्संस, व्हाट दे हैव एक्चुअली डन टू सॉर्ट आउट दिस इशू. कोई इशू नया नहीं आता है, वो पहले भी होता है सोसाइटी में. द थिंग इज जस्ट हु इज रिकॉग्नाइजिंग दोस प्रॉब्लम. एंड इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग इज वंस यू रिकॉग्नाइज दोस प्रॉब्लम, सेकेंड इंपॉर्टेंट स्टेप इज हाउ यू राइट दैट प्रॉब्लम. सो while the teacher or your supervisor ask you to do the review of literature, that is to find out those information that already exist related to your field of interest. Now the next step, once you have gathered all the information, then you have to identify the gaps. Because jaisa maine pehle bhi kaha ki aap research jo hai aaj naya kar rahe ho, aap bol rahe ho ye innovation hai, ye kaam main kar raha hu, lekin it is not that novel ki aaj hi aaya hai. Jaise ki aap abhi currently you all are facing this corona disease, this is not the ekdam latest nahi aaya hai, ye pehle bhi SARS virus ki class ko belong kar chuka hai. Hum already bhi pehle bhi iski ek version se infection dekh chuke hain. We have studied this, kis tarike se log, how people are finding this solution to this issue, kis tarike se log is disease ki cure dhoond rahe hain. It is not that ki ekdam se aap koi bhi cheez bologe ye drug de do and this disease will be, you know, ye disease theek ho jayegi. No, you cannot find. Kis tarike se log, how they are finding? They are finding the gaps. What are the gaps? Kya hai aapki problem mein aur previously published data mein? Kya gap hai beech mein? To identify that gap, you need to know the review of literature. And agar once you have done this review of literature in a proper manner, then you would be able to show the relationships between your data as well as previously published data. Agar aap relationship ya dono ke beech ka link, if you are unable to establish it properly, then nobody is going to accept your notion. Aap chahe koi bhi research kar lo, agar aap proper connection nahi establish kar paye, then it is very hard to make others to accept your knowledge. So once you have done the review of literature, you have gathered all the information, you have, you know, filled that gap. So then the last step, agar aapke paas itna data aa gaya, so definitely you can easily design your research framework. Or design matlab, you can create all the steps or the methods which are needed to find the solution of your problem. Research is what? Apni problem ka solution dhoondna. So this is all about the purpose why you are being asked to do extensive review of literature, because bina is a step ke you cannot write a good research article, review article, or any research you cannot do without this, without doing this review of literature. So what are the points which you need to consider for doing this literature review? Aisa nahi hai ki aap kuch bhi data padhte raho, kitna bhi padhte raho. That will only waste your time. As I said in my outcome section, or you can say outline of the lecture, as I said, ki very important to manage time. Because aap agar timely nahi koi cheez execute karoge, 10 saal aap ek cheez ki research hi karte rahoge, ya kitna padh loge? What to study? How much to study? That is very important. ठीक है, इट इज नॉट राइट कि आप कुछ भी पढ़ते रहो. वंस यू हैव आइडेंटिफाइड योर प्रॉब्लम, देन यू नीड टू बी वेरी स्पेसिफिक. आप किस रिसर्च को पढ़ोगे? ओनली यू शुड स्टडी स्पेसिफिक एंड रेलिवेंट डेटा, राइट? यू शुड बी सिलेक्टिव, फोकस ऑन द करेंट टॉपिक्स. That means what is the current research which is going on that particular area. Jo bhi aapne choose kiya hai apna research problem, identify that what is going on, what people, other people are doing in this arena. How can I make myself different from them? So you need to identify strength and weakness of your study, as well as you should focus on the source of evidence. It's very important ki aapne kahan se data collect kiya hai. There are various portals which are not authentic, where from where you can attend these thing. Aap wahan se nahi le sakte. So it's very important that you need to focus on the source of evidence, right? And the very important aspect is that, okay, aapne koi bhi source le liya, there should be some your contrary evidences also, which contradict your study also. Ki is tarike se humne aap unhe dikhayenge how you can establish this relationship also. And the most important thing is that reference citation and avoid plagiarism. I would be discussing all it in detail in the next slides. So these are the different resources from where you can do your literature review, like all the journals, reports, previously published thesis of various PhD scholars, books, encyclopedias. There are various electronic databases from where you can get the literature review. How you do literature review? Hame teacher hame keh deta hai, okay, do the literature review. But many of my students ask, ma'am, how to do this literature review? So I have tried to show in this slide that you should, firstly, I will never recommend you to use Google, because many of us, what we do whenever we find an issue, we generally type it in Google and find it out. That no, if you are a future researcher or research scholar, or even if you are a faculty members, I would request you all to please use Google Scholar instead of Google or any other scientific portal which is authentic. So Google Scholar, यहाँ पर आपको जितने भी authentic research हैं, you will get here all the authentic research in this field. अब जिसका जो भी scientific जितना भी data होगा, you will get in the Google. Now how you will do? Now how you will do? Question comes, आप किस तरीके से करोगे literature review? So it's very simple way that if you want to do this literature review, Google Scholar mein, in your search button, you just have to type your important words. Like suppose maine isme type karne ki koshish ki hai, because main gallbladder cancer ka treatment karna chahti hu by the use of plant products. Aap natural compound se main treatment dhoondna chah rahi hu. So I have written my important keywords. That's why I said ki agar aap literature review acche se karoge, you would be able to find out these words, specific words, including jaise ki aapka jo bhi topic ho. If someone wants to explore COVID-19 ka main treatment karna chah raha hu, ya COVID-19 ke liye if I want to main koi machine banana chah raha hu, then how, what you will do? You will write COVID-19 plus. This plus indicates that you are connecting all the keywords together. तो जितने भी research articles related होंगे आपके इस area of interest which you have typed in this particular section, you will get that research. These are the different papers. In this manner, you will get the results. So whatever people have done in this gallbladder cancer, I will get all the research article. I have shown only a smaller glimpse, but आप इसको detail में भी देख सकते हो. Now coming to the first part, that is your title and abstract. कोई भी research problem या research paper जब आप लिखते हो तो सबसे जरूरी है you need to have a very impressive title. Because अगर आपका title weak रहा, nobody is going to put show any kind of interest in your research article. This is one of my publication which I have done in this Noida Institute of Engineering and Technology. Here I have published this data. What I have tried to done in this, I have tried to find out the effect of this Moringa oleifera plant drumstick, जो कि आप generally सांबर में खाते होंगे. मैंने कोशिश की क्या उस drumstick से हम cervical cancer के लिए कोई treatment search out कर सकते हैं. Can we do something? Although मैंने अभी I have not done it on that level, but yes, I have tried to find out कि क्या उन पत्तियों से हम down regulate, या हम उस particular gene जो कि वो cancer कर रही है, can we down regulate it? क्या हम उसके expression को कम कर सकते हैं, so that कि cancer के patients में at least हम कुछ हद तक contribute कर सके. So the title is very important because title should be very, not to be very small, not to be very long. It should be very precise and it should explain the purpose of your study. उसमें वो सारे keywords आने चाहिए जो आपकी research को explain कर दें. आप इस title में देख सकते हो कि इस क्या क्या चीजें involved हैं. Title से ही आपको पूरी study समझ में आ जाएगी कि क्या काम किया गया है, हमने क्या क्या काम किया है. As you can see in the title, we have done work on cervical cancer for which we have selected a particular gene as well as हमने plant product को use किया है और ये एक therapeutic approach है. I hope you all will agree that in this title itself, you get the clear picture of my research work. Now the important thing is that you should write a proper abstract. Once you have finalized your title, then the most important thing जो आपके paper में जरूरी होता है, या even आप कभी research proposal भी कहीं लिखोगे किसी agency को, you need to write an effective abstract. How you can write it effectively? Abstract में first of all you should tell the scope of your study. What is the scope of your study? Why you are conducting it? And you should explain the importance of your study only in 2-3 lines, not in a big one big whole page or paragraph. No, only in 2-3 lines you should completely explain the importance or relevance of the study. And then the next thing is that you should explain the method. Not explain, you should just provide a glimpse of the methods which you have used to carry out your research. पूरा एक्सप्लेन कर दोगे तो कोई आपका रिसर्च पेपर नहीं पढ़ेगा. तो बहुत ही प्रेसाइज वे में शॉर्ट ग्लिम्स दीजिए, अपनी टेक्निक्स का नाम सिर्फ लिखिए, सो दैट पीपल गेट अट्रैक्टेड. ओके फाइन, दीज आर द डिफरेंट टेक्निक्स दिस पर्टिकुलर रिसर्चर हैज यूज्ड, सो वी शुड गो इट इन डिटेल. एंड द नेक्स्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग इज यू शुड ओनली राइट इंपॉर्टेंट और द सिग्निफिकेंट रिजल्ट ऑफ द स्टडी. वो भी वो रिजल्ट आप इस तरीके से लिखो जो कि आपकी रिसर्च की कंक्लूजन को अच्छी तरीके से एक्सप्लेन कर सके. एंड द लास्ट एंड द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग ऑफ योर एब्स्ट्रैक्ट इज यू शुड राइट वन लाइन फ्यूचर आउटकम ऑफ योर स्टडी. That what, how this study will be beneficial. क्या कर सकते हैं फ्यूचर में इससे. सपोज मैंने कहा कि हाँ ड्रमस्टिक से आप जैवन को इनहिबिट कर सकते हो, तो क्या करें इनहिबिट करके. What is the future outcome? Future outcome is further आप इसको as a drug candidate use कर सकते हो. Then the next section which comes is introduction. आपने title लिख लिया, you have written the abstract. Now the next thing is your introduction. Introduction कभी भी यू शुड नॉट राइट इट मोर देन 1.5 and 2 पेजेस. कभी भी इससे ज्यादा आप इंट्रोडक्शन नहीं लिखना चाहिए बिकॉज दैट इज नॉट जनरली एक्सेप्टेबल बाय द जर्नल. जिस भी जर्नल में आप पब्लिश करोगे या इवन आप किसी एजेंसी में भी अपनी रिसर्च भेजोगे, देन ऑल्सो पीपल आर नॉट इंटरेस्टिंग इन रीडिंग योर होल रामायणा. दे आर ओनली इंटरेस्टेड इन रीडिंग द जेस्ट. जितना इफेक्टिव और कम में आप अपना रिसर्च प्रेजेंट कर पाओगे, दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. इंट्रोडक्शन बहुत वाइड नहीं होना चाहिए, इट शुड बी वेरी क्रिस्प एंड वेरी प्रसाइज और सारी चीजें कंक्लूड भी करें. इतना भी क्रिस्प और प्रसाइज मत करो कि मेन इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग ही उससे छूट जाए. सो द इंट्रोडक्शन शुड कंटेन व्हाट इज नोन. आपकी जो भी रिसर्च, आपने जो भी रिसर्च टॉपिक सोचा है उसके बारे में क्या पता है, क्या नहीं पता है, यू शुड इंक्लूड, बिकॉज दीज आर द टू वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एस्पेक्ट्स विच यू शुड कंसिडर ड्यूरिंग राइटिंग इंट्रोडक्शन. दैट इज व्हाट इज नोन एंड व्हाट इज अननोन. एंड नेक्स्ट थिंग इज दैट आप क्या आइडेंटिफाई करना चाहते हो, व्हाट इज द गैप विच वी वॉन्ट टू फिल. और गैप आप कब आइडेंटिफाई, कब लिख पाओगे, जब आपको पास्ट पता है और आपको ये पता है कि ये नहीं पता है, तभी आप उसके बीच का गैप फिल कर पाओगे. एंड द नेक्स्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग इज हाउ यू विल फिल दिस गैप. एंड द लास्ट इज योर व्हाट इज द पर्पस ऑफ डूइंग दिस रिसर्च. तो आई होप यू गॉट अ लिटिल स्मॉल पिक्चर अबाउट दिस व्हाट टू राइट इन द इंट्रोडक्शन पार्ट. And the most important thing, it should not cross 2-page limit. There is a word limit always. कभी भी आप किसी जर्नल में कोई भी रिसर्च पेपर पब्लिश करोगे, सबमिट करोगे, तो ऑलवेज आपको बताया जाता है कि ओके दिस इज द वर्ड लिमिट, यू कैनॉट गो बियॉन्ड दैट. सो अगर आपको प्रिसाइज लिखना है इंट्रोडक्शन, सो ऑलवेज फोकस ऑन दीज 5 पॉइंट्स. व्हाट इज नोन, व्हाट इज अननोन, एंड व्हाट इज द गैप यू वॉन्ट टू फिल, एंड मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग इज हाउ यू फिल. And what is the purpose behind doing this, behind writing this introduction, or you can say behind conducting this research. Now the next section which comes after this introduction, now you have introduced everything to your audience, jiske bhi samne wo paper jayega, aapne introduction de di, okay ye pata tha, ye nahi pata tha, and all thing. Now how you have achieved that, how you have solved that issue, that comes your materials and methods. Material is very important because no one will believe aapne kya use kiya if you will not let them to know that what are the different steps you have performed to achieve that result. Aapka result authentic hi nahi rahega, nobody will believe on you. So material means all the details of reagents, what are the chemicals, or jo bhi aapne equipment, suppliers, you have to give the details of suppliers also, from where you have procured those reagents. It is very important for you to explain these things, because if you are unable to prove the details of these materials, journal is not going to accept your article. So it is very important to provide the details of the reagents, about your equipments, as well as their suppliers. Then comes methods. Methods is simple, the steps which you have done to get the result of your work. Why this is needed? Because obviously, aaj aap ye result publish kar rahe ho, in future, someone is going to use your data to do their research. Agar aap effective way mein apna material and methodology nahi likhoge, why the other person will cite your paper? Wo aapke paper ko kyun reference lega? Aapke paper ko wo apne paper mein cite kyun karega? If you have, agar aap achhe se material and methodology explain nahi karoge. So you should provide enough information to reproduce the experiment for the future researchers. Then the main important part of your work is your result. That is the heart of the paper. Why I'm calling it the heart of the paper? Because this will only, abhi tak to humne sab hawa hawa hi baate ki. Okay, this is the introduction, this is what is known, unknown, and everything. We have done everything. But until and unless, wo hai na, log bolte hain, what is the result? Kya aaya, wo batao. Don't explain me, okay, ye kahani. Nobody is interested in stories, my dear friends. So you need to present or explain your findings. So this section is very important, because here in this section, aapko bahut hi smart way mein, you have to explain your findings. The most important thing is that you should use past tense, because kai baar hamare student likhte hain and they generally present form mein hi likhte chale jaate hain. No, you should always use past tense while writing this result section. An important part is you should never interpret this, because this interpretation will be done in the next section. So aap yahan sirf apni findings batao that we have done this, ye cheez humne study ki, is drug ka itna itna effect dekha humne 24 ghante ke liye, we have performed the experiments and this has shown this result. Don't do the interpretation, because it will be done in the discussion part. So ye generally hum galti kar dete hain, hum result mein hi sari cheeze interpret कर देते हैं, so we have nothing to write in the discussion part. So you need to only explain your findings, not interpretation. एंड इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग इज इट शुड बी ऑर्गेनाइज. ऐसा नहीं है आप किसी भी एक्सपेरिमेंट को ऊपर कर दो एंड देन. इट शुड बी अरेंज इन अ सिक्वेंशियल मैनर. इट शुड बी लॉजिकल दैट ओके दिस स्टेप इज डन. दैट्स वाई इसी के कंटिन्यूएशन में वी आर परफॉर्मिंग द नेक्स्ट स्टेप. सो इट शुड बी वेरी मच ऑर्गेनाइज एज वेल एज लॉजिकल. And foremost important thing is that it should be very clear and simple. बहुत ज़्यादा complicated English या बहुत ज़्यादा आपको लिखने की there is no need. It should be clear and it should be simple enough so that even a layman person can also under. अब ये भी नहीं है कि आप scientific terminology मत use करो. No, always use scientific words to write your scientific research. और अगर आप arts या किसी और branch में लिख रहे हो तो it's fine, you can use any terminologies. But for engineering students as well as pharmacists, you can say it is very important to use the scientific words to write these result. Then the next important part is discussion. As I said in my previous slide, ki you need not to interpret your results. Because kai journals to bolte hain, okay, fine, aap research, result and discussion ek hi section mein de sakte ho. But yahan par kya hota hai? In discussion section, you have to interpret your result. You have to establish a correlation with the previous research. Aapko ye batana padta hai ki how your research is different from them, how your data is more significant. Ye aapko ek ek apni result finding se establish karna padta hai that how your research is different from them and how it is significant, right? As well as in discussion part, you need to explain the limitations of your study. Kyunki koi ek hi research mein sab kuch nahi explain kar sakta. So you have to explain, okay, these are some of the limitations related to this study. As well as you need to tell ki aapke research se future mein aur kya kya kiya ja sakta hai. This is very important because jab paper, because what I have found till now, people used to read the discussion of your paper because from that only, आपको उनकी last two lines अगर आप study करोगे, तो you got to know, okay, ये हो चुका है, this part has not been done. So you can create innovation with the help of reading those last two lines of discussion. I will also tell you in my later slides that how it is helpful. Now, after writing this whole paper, that is, you have included all the different components, you have written the result discussion. The very important thing is your acknowledgement. Acknowledgement means jis bhi organization ne aapko fund kiya hai, financial grant di hai, ya your institute where you have performed those experiments, which has allowed you to perform those experiments, wo kaam karne ke liye aapko permission di hai, aapko ek affiliation diya hai, authorized person banaya hai to do the research, you should always do the acknowledgement of that organization, or you can do the acknowledgement of that special person also. Like suppose if I want to acknowledge my professor who has helped me in designing the whole research paper, so you can do in this section, and you should do. This is an important criteria of any research paper. Then the next is your conflict of interest. Conflict of interest means that you have not published your data in any other journal, or aapke saath jo log involved hain unhe bhi koi objection nahi hai is study ko publish karne ke liye. So this is a very important part, and you agar kisi ko koi hai conflict of interest, so you need to write that statement ki this particular person has this, ya jo bhi cheeze hoti agar kisi ko koi objection, basically you can say, so you will include in this conflict of interest. And the next section is funding. Agar aapko koi financial grant mili hai, if you have received any financial grant, you should mention this name. Like mujhe ye research karne ke liye AKTU CRIP se I have received 3 lakhs grant to perform this particular experiment. That's why I need to explain that this study was funded by CRIP program of AKTU. So in this manner, the whole paper gets concluded. Now the last and foremost important part of your paper is references. References matlab jo bhi aapne previous published data padha hai, unko aapko one by one reference अरेंज करना होता है. आपकी हर एक लाइन, आपने इंट्रोडक्शन में जो भी स्टोरी बनाई है, जो भी स्टोरी लिखी है, उस हर एक लाइन को आपको ऑथेंटिकेट करना होता है. किस तरीके से, आई विल बी शोइंग यू इन द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड्स. Now, this comes how to cite references. किस तरीके से आप करोगे? देखो, it depends on journal to journal. It varies from journal to journal. कोई journal कहता है you need to write the name of the author. Like suppose here you can see the highlighted one, Bray et al. That means Bray is the name of the author. Or you can say author मतलब वो person जिसने वो research conduct की है. And ये et al. What is the meaning of this et al? Et al means not many people are there in the group. Only Bray is not the person who has conducted the whole research, but some other persons are also there who have conducted this research. So this totally depends on the choice of demand of journal. Kis tarike ka wo bol raha hai? Many of the journal ask you to put numbers. Three fourth matlab aapne jo bhi references, jaise ki aapne previous slide mein 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. Similarly, you just need to put the numbers. Whereas some ask you to write the name of those authors. So it depends in which journal you are submitting your work. But the important thing is why the citation is essential. Because kisi ne likh diya ki prostate cancer bahut hi commonly found tumor hai men's mein, Western world mein. Who will believe? Who will believe you if you will write this? No, people will only believe you. The data will be only authentic when you will provide this reference in the braces that Bray et al. 2018 में उन्होंने अपनी जो publish की है study, उससे मैंने ये data लिया है. It is the authentic line. So, introduction part and in your discussion part or even in your methodology part, you need to use references. I hope अब आप लोग को पता चला होगा कि how to cite references in manuscript. अब कहां से आप इन references को collect कर सकते हो? Obviously, as I said earlier, in the Google Scholar, आप इस तरीके से you will find different research papers which you have studied, which you have collected to write the paper. तो वहां पर आपको ये double quotes, you will see these double quotes. Arrow कि अगर आप अपर पार्ट में देख रहे होगे दीज डबल कोट्स, व्हेन यू विल क्लिक ऑन दीज डबल कोट्स, देन अ स्क्रीन विल ओपन लाइक दिस. साइट, साइट मींस यू कैन कॉपी द रेफरेंसेस फ्रॉम हियर. क्योंकि हर एक जर्नल का अपना अपना स्टाइल होता है. एज आई सेड अर्लियर, हर एक जर्नल अलग अलग स्टाइल में बोलता है ये आपको रेफरेंसेस साइट करने हैं. देयर आर डिफरेंट स्टाइल्स इंक्लूडिंग एपीए, शिकागो, हार्वर्ड. दीज आर ऑल व्हाट, दीज आर द डिफरेंट स्टाइल्स इन विच यू कैन राइट योर रेफरेंसेस. दिस वेरीज फ्रॉम जर्नल टू जर्नल, राइट? सो बाय क्लिकिंग ऑन दीज टू कोट्स यू कैन गेट दीज different formats. Only these are not the limited one. ऐसा नहीं है कि सारे journal यही follow करते हैं 5. इसके अलावा भी many journals have designed their own formats. वो अपना ही format रखते हैं. Somebody ask you to don't write the name Pandey first. They ask you to write Pratibha first or Pandey as make it as P or whatever. So these are the different formats or you can say style in which the journal ask you to cite your references. But most important ones I have shown here that you can get from here also. And directly copy it and या paste कर लो अगर APA format में journal demand कर रहा है तो. Apart from clicking it one by one here, यहाँ से आप, और फिर मान लो journal ने बोला नहीं हमें in different styles में नहीं करना है, so there are different tools also which will help you to arrange your these references, right? It will help you to arrange. So यहाँ पर आपको क्या होगा, इस तरीके से आप references arrange कर सकते हो according to the demand of the journal. अब आपका पूरा paper prepare हो गया, ठीक है? You have prepared all your paper. Now the next and the very important thing which you should be very much careful, plagiarism. Because हम लोग क्या करते हैं, copy paste, as we all do. हम क्या करते हैं, प्रीवियस पेपर से डेटा लिया, वी हैव कॉपीड इट एंड पेस्टेड इन, और हम सोच लेते हैं ओ वी हैव डन अ गुड लिटरेचर, वी हैव रिटन एवरीथिंग. नो, ईच एंड एवरी सिंगल वर्ड विल गेट मींस डिटेक्टेड. आप जो भी सेंटेंस कॉपी करते हो दैट विल गेट डिटेक्टेड. सो यही जो कॉपी है ना, ये कॉपी करना, दिस इज योर प्लैगरिज्म. आपका पेपर तो बन गया, अब आप उस पेपर को, पहले हमें चेक करना होता है कि वो प्लैगराइज्ड डेटा तो नहीं है, कॉपीड डेटा तो नहीं है किसी से. So, ये टर्मिनोलॉजी ही आई प्लैगरिज्म. ये टर्मिनोलॉजी कहां से आई, ये वर्ड कहां से आया? दिस वर्ड केम फ्रॉम अ लैटिन वर्ड, प्लैगियरस मींस किडनैपर, जिसने किसी को किडनैप कर लिया, डेटा को रख लिया है. तो प्लैगरिज्म इज व्हाट, इट इज नथिंग बट इट इज एन act of presenting another work as your own. किसी दूसरे के काम को आप दिखा दो, ये आपके रिसर्च वर्क है, और रिसर्च फील्ड में ये एक बहुत ही बड़ा क्राइम है. और आप इस तरीके से इफ यू विल डू, नो जर्नल इज गोइंग टू एक्सेप्ट योर रिसर्च वर्क. सो यू शुड बी वेरी क्लियर केयरफुल टू हैव दिस कॉन्सेप्ट क्लियर. योर डेटा शुड नॉट बी प्लैगराइज्ड. देयर आर सर्टेन सॉफ्टवेयर्स, कुछ फ्रीली भी अवेलेबल है. सर्टेन सॉफ्टवेयर्स आर देयर जो कि आपके इंस्टीट्यूशंस प्रोवाइड करते हैं, बिकॉज दे आर वेरी वो कॉस्टलियर होते हैं, यू कैन नॉट इजली गेट देम. सो आपके इंस्टीट्यूशंस में दे प्रोवाइड यू दो सॉफ्टवेयर्स टू चेक द डेटा. आप अपने डेटा को पहले, बिफोर सबमिटिंग इट टू जर्नल, यू शुड गेट इट चेक्ड बाई दीज सॉफ्टवेयर्स. वन ऑफ फ्यू सॉफ्टवेयर्स आई हैव ट्राइड टू शो इन दिस, बिकॉज अगेन एज आई सेड, पूरा एक लेक्चर लग जाएगा प्लैगरिज्म सॉफ्टवेयर्स को ही एक्सप्लेन करने में. सो एक ग्लिम्स दे रही हूँ आप लोग को, दैट दीज आर द डिफरेंट सॉफ्टवेयर्स विच आर फ्रीली ऑनलाइन, यू कैन एक्सेस देम टू फाइंड द प्लैगरिज्म कंटेंट. Grammarly is there, completely fully free nahi hai, but yes, 1000 words you can scan one in a time. So this is a software, Grammarly, which will again, there is one another tool, that is a small CO tools, which is again an online software, but we cannot trust on it completely. But yes, you can get a little bit idea about ki aapka data kahan kahan se copied hai, but Grammarly is one of the trustworthy software, 100% trustworthy software. Apart from this, इस तरीके से आपकी plagiarism report आती है. Suppose I have written a paper, मैंने एक research paper लिखा, this is the title of my paper, इसने show किया, report आई, 5% data आपका match कर रहा है. Generally journals का criteria होता है 15%, 10% वो plagiarism acceptable करते हैं. 10% से ज्यादा plagiarism होगा या 15% से, they will not accept your research article. So you should be very careful. अगर आप देख रहे होगे ध्यान से, जहां भी उसे कोई भी लाइन मैच करती हुई दिख जाएगी, कोई भी सेंटेंस मैच करता हुआ दिख जाएगा, तुरंत आपका सॉफ्टवेयर इस चीज को देखा, you have these lines from this particular paper. So this is very important. हमारी सीरीज जो भी आगे चलेंगे लेक्चर्स, तो ये हम डिटेल में आप लोग को बताएंगे कि किस तरीके से प्लैगरिज्म, हाउ यू कैन रिमूव प्लैगरिज्म, हाउ यू कैन डिटेक्ट दिस. सो वी वुड बी डिस्कसिंग इन आर लेटर सीरीज. नाउ द नेक्स्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग इज सबमिट कहाँ करें, वेयर टू सबमिट, हाउ टू फाइंड जर्नल्स. ये बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन आता है, हम जर्नल कहाँ फाइंड करें, और सही जर्नल सेलेक्ट करना सबसे इंपॉर्टेंट एस्पेक्ट है फॉर डूइंग योर इफेक्टिव रिसर्च. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, अगर हम इंडियन सिनेरियो में बात करें, तो यू शुड फर्स्ट सी द यूजीसी अप्रूव्ड लिस्ट ऑफ जर्नल्स. फ्रॉम दिस यू शुड डाउनलोड द लिस्ट सो एज टू गेट द ऑथेंटिक जर्नल्स. बहुत ही फेक और प्रेडेटरी जर्नल्स हैं, यू शुड फर्स्ट ट्राई आउट, फाइंड आउट कि ये जर्नल यूजीसी लिस्ट में आर दे लिस्टेड ओवर देयर. बिकॉज आप अपना डेटा पब्लिश कर लो, देन आपको पता चले अरे इस जर्नल की तो कोई सिग्निफिकेंस है ही नहीं, दिस इज नॉट द रिकॉग्नाइज्ड वन. भाई आप गोल्ड भी खरीदते हो तो देखते हो ना ये मार्क हो. तो इसी तरीके से अगर आप जर्नल भी अपना पेपर पब्लिश कर रहे हो, अपना इंपॉर्टेंट फाइंडिंग पब्लिश कर रहे हो, यू नीड टू ऑथेंटिकेट द जर्नल. आप कहाँ कर रहे हो, सो दिस इज वन ऑफ द साइट फ्रॉम वेयर यू कैन गेट द लिस्ट ऑफ जर्नल्स. अगेन इसके अलावा नॉट ओनली द यूजीसी, बट यू कैन means find out better journals or authentic journals in your SCI index journals, which you can get it from Google. Aapke SCI index journals, wahan se aap, you can get the access. This is the your SCI site from where you can, jaise ki maine ek type box mein likha hai, I have written the name Nutrition and Cancer. I have to check whether this journal is authentic or not. You just write the name over here and click search journals. What will come? The result will come like this. Okay, Nutrition and Cancer, this is an SCI expanded journal. That means this journal is authentic, because these are the certain organizations which are very much needed to make any journal authentic. So this journal is good. Once I get this detail that yes, this is SCI expanded. So again, there is one another portal, that is your Scopus. This is also you can say database, or you can say authentic site where you can get the details of your paper. Similarly, I have written this title, Nutrition and Cancer, and when I clicked on it, I found the details. Or agar aapka journal nahi Scopus indexed hoga, that means authentic nahi hoga, that will not come here, and you will get found zero results. So these are some of the sites from where you can check the authenticity of the journal, that whether it is predatory or it is the authentic one. Because ek baar aapne data publish kar liya fake mein, predatory mein, to aapka wo data gaya, you won't be able to. तो डेटा भी जाए, आपकी फाइंडिंग्स भी जाए, इट इज नॉट एट ऑल गुड. सो बेटर डू दिस फर्स्ट टू चेक द ऑथेंटिसिटी ऑफ द जर्नल. अपार्ट फ्रॉम एक तो आपके प्रोफेसर सजेस्ट करते हैं, ओके विच आर द जर्नल्स यू शुड यू कैन मींस आप जहां अपना पेपर सबमिट कर सकते हो, बट देयर आर सर्टेन साइट्स ऑल्सो विच हेल्प यू टू फाइंड द बेटर जर्नल, ऑथेंटिक जर्नल्स. इट दे आर प्रोवाइडेड बाई विले. हेयर यू कैन राइट द मैन्युस्क्रिप्ट टाइटल एंड एब्स्ट्रैक्ट, एंड यू कैन get a number of list of journals जो कि आपके area of research से match करते होंगे. There are Springer journal suggester by which you can find again journal. ये सब आप लोग authentic नाम सुनते होंगे, Wille, Springer, Taylor and Francis. These are very you can say known journals जो कि बहुत ही known है और authentic journals हैं. So इनकी अपनी भी sites है from where you can find journal related to your area of interest, so that आपका time नहीं waste होगा. आप किसी भी journal में डालोगे definitely आपके time waste होगा, वो एक महीने बाद आपको reply देगा it is not matching with the theme. So it's better to do the research first. Submit करने से पहले ही अगर आप यहाँ पर search कर लोगे कि okay match, ये आपका match criteria बता देगा 10%, 30%, 40% match कर रहा है, okay जिससे maximum match करे आप submit your research into that particular journal. Again, this is also one of the source from where you can find journals. SCI means there also you can find the journals. This is the web page of one of the journal जो इतनी देर से हम बात कर रहे थे, Nutrition and Cancer. अब हम उस particular journal का I am showing you the show means home page. Why I am showing this? Because here you get to know the impact factor. I am not going to discuss in detail with this because ye aap subsequent lectures mein you will come to know that what is the significance of this impact factor and all, but it is very important for submitting any paper in the particular journal. You need to have a good impact factor, right? Apart from that, aap yahan par jo hai is तरीके से होम पेज पे यू नीड टू फर्स्ट क्लिक ऑन इंस्ट्रक्शंस फॉर ऑथर्स, बिकॉज यहां से आपको पता चलेगा व्हाट आर देयर स्पेसिफिक रिक्वायरमेंट, कि इनका फॉन्ट साइज 12 होना चाहिए, स्पेसिंग शुड बी लाइक दिस, रेफरेंसेस जैसे आपने देखे इट शुड बी एपीए और वैंक्यूवर एनी द स्टाइल, वर्ड लिमिट्स, व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट मीन साइज ऑफ द फिगर्स दे वॉन्ट फॉर देयर पर्टिकुलर जर्नल. सो ऑल दिस यू विल गेट, और इसी को जब आप केयरफुली स्टडी करोगे देन ओनली यू वुड बी एबल टू डिजाइन अ पर्टिकुलर रिसर्च फॉर दैट पर्टिकुलर जर्नल. नाउ अब हो गया, पेपर पब्लिश कर लिया, अल्टीमेटली क्वेश्चन कम्स, स्टूडेंट आस्क व्हाट वी विल गेट आफ्टर पब्लिशिंग दिस पेपर, मिलेगा क्या हमें पेपर पब्लिश करने में. सो फर्स्ट एंड द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग विच यू विल गेट फ्रॉम दिस पब्लिकेशन इज global recognition. Global recognition means on different platforms you will get means have your own recognition. Aapki ek profile khud generate ho jati hai from where people can see, jo bhi eminent professors ya even koi budding researcher or any student will come to know about you, that okay Dr. Pratibha has done this research in this particular area. So this is a kind of global recognition where distinguished faculty members would be see your research. So these are the different portals where you get recognitions, ORCID as Google Scholar or Publons, ResearchGate. These are the different portals where you will get recognitions. Apart from, you will not get only recognitions, but it will also help you in fetching grants from Government of India. Although we are not going to discuss it in detail in this lecture, but I will show you a glimpse from where you can get these grants. You can get grants from Department of Health Research, BCIL, AICT New Delhi, WASADST, Government of India, and there are certain other departments of Science and Technology, Department of Biotechnology, from where you can get good grants to conduct your research. एक छोटी सी ग्लिम्स मैं आपको दिखा रही हूँ, दैट आई हैव ऑल्सो रिसीव्ड अ ग्रांट. एक रिसर्च आइडिया, छोटा सा रिसर्च आइडिया जो माइंड में आया, एंड आई हैव जस्ट पेंड इट डाउन, एंड ऑन दैट आइडिया ओनली आई गॉट 21 लैक्स 21,56,000 rupees to do my research. It was what? It is nothing but just an idea which I got, and मैंने उसको properly एक framed way में लिखा, as I explained earlier in my previous slides. एक हर एक step में मैंने design किया अच्छे से. How I have written, I got a grant of this much, and I think this is sufficient for a student to do or to conduct their research. So, जो भी research में interested हैं, जो भी faculty interested हैं, please start writing research proposals or start writing research papers so that you can get good grants from Government of India to fulfill all your dreams or to pursue your research. This grant I have received after completion of my M.Tech program. Here I was getting 40,000 rupees to perform this research. So this is just in motivation. इससे भी बड़ी-बड़ी grants होती हैं, 60 lakhs, 70 lakhs. जो लोग ले रहे हैं, people are getting. But for that, you need to do publications. So I ये मैंने इसलिए दिखाया so that कि questions students को doubt रहता है या faculty members या कई लोगों को what you will get after doing this research publication. This is again one of the glimpse of our grant which we have received from AKTU in the last year for performing our very small experiment. Like only we have to find out the means effect of Moringa oleifera seeds in water purification. For this, government has given us 3 lakhs rupees just to perform that experiment. So see how much beneficial if you have learned to write a research paper effectively, or you can say if you have learned a effective way of writing any proposal, you can get good grants from Government of India. Again, I would like to thank you all for patiently listening my lecture. And if you have any query or if you want any kind of help related to research article, research proposal design, or any help related in this field, please feel free to contact me at my mail IDs. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Pratibha. Chief of IRC Cell and Department of Biotechnology, NIIT, I would like to thank Dr. Pratibha for giving such an informative session. And I'm sure all will be benefited with the session, those who are attending the lecture today. I would like to thank our director, sir, Dr. Vinod Kapse, for supporting such an activities on regular basis for the student and faculty, not only for NIIT, but other institutions also. I would like to thank our Vice President, sir, Raman Batra, sir, for continuous support. And he also supports research and development in NIIT. I would like to thank who is not only ISC member, but also M.Tech coordinator in the Department of Biotechnology for organizing such an event, which is very informative to all the students and for the faculty member. And lastly, I would like to thank all the participants for attending it very carefully and making it a success. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for giving me such a nice vote of thanks, ma'am. Apart from that, I am really thankful to all my listeners who have shown this much sincere interest in my lecture. Thank you so much for patiently listening this lecture. Thank you, Arvind sir, for providing me this opportunity to have a discussion with all the listeners. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Pratibha, ma'am. We are so grateful for your expensive time. Now, I would like to request all the participants. You can also log into our Facebook channel of NIIT and the YouTube channel. There you can find all the videos and the things that are there related to the webinar and seminars that NIIT organizes. And you can also get the video of the same event there on the YouTube channel of the NIIT. As well as we also have one department YouTube channel. There also you can get the details of the events that department organizes, and you will get all the videos feedback there. So we hope to see you again. Thank you for thanks to all of you for being with us. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, sir.